and welcome back to a new challenge quiz thing video on my channel. And as you can see, I'm already dressed up for Halloween. And to all of you who are watching this now or maybe tomorrow, I'm not actually sure when I will be able to post this video. Happy Halloween, everyone. So I just thought that I should do a little special video dedicated to Halloween. And I'm dressed up pretty ridiculously, as you can see. This is not my Halloween costume, of course. I still need to finish that before, you know, tomorrow, because when I'm recording this video, tomorrow will be Halloween. But I just wanted to, you know, throw some silly stuff on me and make sure that this video is in the mood of Halloween. And as you can see, I got some creepy nails, which is, they're kind of hard to work with, actually, with these gloves. So I'm probably going to get rid of them pretty soon. And I got this cute little headband thingy. And by the way, the little pumpkins actually do light up. I'm not sure if you can see that because it's a pretty sunny mood outside. So not all that gloomy and Halloween-y, but you know, what can you do? And by the way, I actually, before I started this video, I was searching through my closet to find a shirt with the Halloween theme, and I just noticed that I don't have any Halloween themed shirts, so I definitely have to grab something for until next year or something like that. I don't know, I have to find one. So I just threw on a Dracula themed shirt because, you know, it's creepy, it's a little bit, you know, kind of similar to Halloween, or I'm not sure how to explain it. It just made me thought of Halloween. In this video, I wanted to talk about, or more likely make a little challenge. Not really a challenge, a 30-day challenge that I usually do this on my channel from time to time. And this is a scary movie challenge. And yes, I'm going to get rid of these gloves because they are really annoying. I have my phone here, and it's called the 30-day horror movie challenge. And you know, we have 30 questions here, and I'm just going to answer them, all of them, in this video. So I'm not going to, if I would have made this, I should have started at the start of October, but I wouldn't have had the time to actually make a video with just one answer every single day and, you know, post it on my channel. So yeah, that's why I'm doing all of it on this video right now. So yeah, I'm just going to stop blabbering now and get on with this challenge. By the way, the challenge is from Amino Apps website, so I have no idea who made this challenge. You can go ahead and search for it, I don't know. So the first question, first horror movie you ever saw? Well, this is a really difficult question because I have been watching horror movies since I was really, really a little kid. I remember watching it with my mom because my mom is a horror movie fan as well. So, you know, as far as I can remember back, I think it was Ghostbusters, one of the Ghostbusters movies. I have no idea which one. I don't think I have watched the Ghostbusters movies ever again. But I remember this, there's this picture in my head, and I know it's from one of the Ghostbusters movies, when a gargoyle, or maybe it was a wolf statue, honestly, again, I can't remember, and I knew that it was started to become like real. And yeah, that's all I can remember. So I'm pretty sure that was the first, like, if I can count the Ghostbusters movies as horror movies, that was the first one that I remember. So maybe that was the first one I ever saw, I have no idea. But let's count it as that. The second question, most recent horror movie we watched. I haven't watched one, or actually any kind of movies in a while. I didn't have time, but we watched with my best friend the Insidious movies. And yeah, the last part of that, the Last Key or whatever was the title of the movie. So the last, the most recent part of the that movie franchise that came out. So yeah, that was the last one. Question three: horror movie you love that everyone else hates. Again, really difficult, but I have a movie in mind that I know a lot of people really, really don't just don't like it, and that's called Bones. I think it was made in 2000 something, and you know, the main character is Jimmy Bones, played by Snoop Dogg. And yeah, I just think that everyone, as far as I saw on the internet, hates that movie, but I really like it. And I saw it multiple times, so yeah, that's one of them. Question four, goriest horror movie you ever saw? I actually don't think I saw any of the movies that I saw. I don't think any of them were that gory. I honestly can't remember any of them. I never actually saw the Saw movies. I know those are pretty gory. Yeah, I don't know, maybe the Nightmare on Elm Street. I know those aren't really that gory, but other than that, I really can't remember. I mean, I saw a lot of horror movies, but the like the recently made ones just weren't that interesting, so I usually forget them pretty quickly. Yeah, I don't know. I honestly can't remember a like really gory movie at all. Question five: the favorite horror movie. My all-time favorite horror and comedy movie is Beetlejuice. So, but I have a lot of favorites. So, but that one is probably my most favorite. Six, funniest horror movie you've seen. It's again Beetlejuice, because it was really funny and I love it since I was a kid. And the other funniest one is I'm pretty sure it's the Nightmare on Elm Street, the sixth movie. Yes. What was the name of it? Oh god, I'm having a brain fart. I just woke up not long ago, and that's probably why. Can't remember, but it was the sixth movie, which is, I know, again, a lot of people hate, but I actually really, really like it because I think it's super funny. So yeah, that's one of the other funniest ones. Question seven, horror movie with the worst sequels. Again, a really good question. And I'm trying to think of the movies that have a lot of sequels, and I actually saw all of them or something like that. I think Hellraiser. I mean, the first like three movies of Hellraiser was really good, and after that it just went downhill. I mean, I saw all of them, but really just no. I think it was after the third movie, the third or the fourth one, I can't remember, because I saw them quite a few years ago. For the first time, by the way, my BFF showed me Hellraiser. Until then, I didn't actually know about it, so that was really cool. But yeah, I think Hellraiser was probably one of the movies that had really bad sequels. Next question is, best horror movie reboot. I usually skip reboots because I hate them. But I think was it Evil Dead? I think it was Evil Dead. Again, saw it a long time ago. but I know that movie had a really, I think, in my opinion, a really cool reboot. Or the Night of the Evil Dead, or was it just Evil Dead? Again, you can bash me in the comments, I can't remember. But I think that was the one of the best reboots. Next question is horror movie with the best villain. Honestly, I mean, the horror movies are all about, usually all about the villains, so I just can't choose one. Fred Krueger was awesome, Jason was awesome, Mike Myers was awesome, Pinhead, yeah, just, I can't choose just one. Horror movie you hate that everyone else loves. Oh god, Oh, by the way, I just remembered, sorry about that. The best horror movie reboot, also, it's probably the It. I really, really liked It, you know, the new version that, or the first part of the new version. So yeah, that's one of the best reboots, I guess. Yeah, so horror movie that everyone hates, that I hate and everyone else loves. Again, honestly, I should have searched on the internet before I did this. Maybe it was the first movie of Annabelle? I mean, I don't really hate it, but it was pretty bad, in my opinion. The second movie was good. I mean, it was almost like real good, but the first movie was just boring in my opinion, so yeah, that's probably one of it. Best horror movie with a disappointing ending. Disappointing ending. I know that there were quite a few. But, in a way, I think I was pretty disappointed with the Freddy vs. Jason ending. I mean, it was cool that, and I don't think it's a spoiler anymore, but I think it was cool that, you know, Jason was taking Freddy's head to his cabin or whatever, and, you know, Freddy's head just winked at us. It was a pretty cool thing, but it just felt like it needed something a little bit more, and I know that they originally were planning to include Pinhead in the ending and Pinhead taking both of them down to hell, and I think that would have been amazing to include that little scene there in the end, so I think that was a bit disappointing, at least for me. Question 12. Least favorite horror movie ever. I don't know. I mean, if I'm interested in a horror movie, then I watch it, obviously, and I don't know if I have a least favorite. I mean, yeah, sure, there are some of them that I don't really like I said before, the Annabelle movie, but I'm not a really big fan of either Jason or Mike Myers, to be honest, so they are not like my least favorite, but I'm not really a big fan of those either. So, I don't know. I don't think I have one. A horror movie you've been meaning to see but haven't. I want to watch all of the Return of the Living Dead. There are so many movies with involving Living Dead that I kind of get confused from time to time, but I think it was the Return of the Living Dead. Or was it Night of the Living Dead? Again, I have no idea. Those first ever zombie movies that they were made. I really like the second one, the second movie. The first one was kind of meh. And the third one, I can't remember if I saw the third one. So yeah, I want to see all of those. And I also want to see the what was it called? The Rob Zombie movies? I don't think I saw those either. Want to see the Silent Hill Nightmare. So yeah, I have quite a few that I want to see or want to watch. Yeah. So probably those. Horror movie with the best sequels. I think Nightmare on Elm Street had some great sequels. The second movie was kind of eh, but the other ones, I really liked them. Yeah, that's probably my my favorite from all of the sequels that came out. I know I keep talking about almost the same movies, but those are what just pop into my mind right now. Yeah. Worst horror movie reboot. Again, it's The Nightmare on Elm Street. The 2010 version was just horrible. And honestly, I never saw it because I don't want to watch it. Horror movie with the terrible acting. I mean, so much of the newer movies that came out were just really, really bad acting, and you know, just those low budget movies. I think there was one called Hangman or something like that. I don't know. These movies just slipped my mind so easily because they were horrible, probably. Cheesiest horror movie. I mean, cheesiest. What? I mean, if you are watching a horror movie, it's a typical horror movie. So, by the way, when we are calling it the worst, with terrible acting and worst horror movie and probably cheesiest, one of the cheesiest horror movie, I don't remember the title of the movie, but there was one with some little puppets, or more like dolls, coming to life and killing everyone in a house, and the girls and guys, they were just like, they should have fled the house a long time ago, and they were still sticking around for no obvious reason, and it was just really, really bad and terrible, so, and really cheesy too. So yeah, I don't, honestly don't remember again the title of that video, I mean not video, movie. Horror movie, the worst plot. Again, these are just the kind of questions that I don't have a specific answer, because some of them were really bad. Like, there was this one movie that I saw quite a few years ago, and it was a long, long time ago. I think it was Texas Werewolf something. It was about the Chupacabra, and it was a really, I thought it was a good movie when I downloaded it, but after I saw it, it was just really, really bad. The monster looked absolutely ridiculous, and you could only see the monster like, what, two times in the movie, and otherwise it was just super boring, stupid. Yeah, so one of the, probably one of the worst, with worst plot and worst movies. Best horror movie soundtrack. There were a lot of good soundtracks out there, especially composed by Danny Elfman. So for Beetlejuice, and yeah, I really like the Addams Family soundtrack as well. So yeah, there are a lot of really cool ones, and yeah, we are not talking about movie, but I really like the theme song, or the theme melody, because it's not really a song, it's just a melody, for the Tales from the Crypt series. Horror movie title that best describes your life. I can't think honestly of one of. I don't know. I don't think any of the horror movie titles really describe my life. Maybe Halloween, because I really like Halloween, and I have some Halloween decorations and, you know, horror stuff in my room all year, so maybe Halloween. So question 21, 22 and 23 are the best horror movie in the 70s, 80s and 90s. That's pretty hard for me because I usually don't remember which movie came out in which year. I know that from the 80s it's probably Beetlejuice, it came out in 89. From the 70s, 78, it was, I think it was the first Nightmare on Elm Street. And 90s, maybe Dracula. The one with in 92. I don't know if you can, I think we can count it as a horror movie because it's about Dracula. The one where Dracula was played by Gary Oldman. So yeah, that's probably from the 90s, maybe. I can't remember any of the other ones, so. Or, I don't know, as I said before, I don't know which movie in which year came out, so yeah. The best genre of horror. I don't know how many out there, I never really cared that much. It's a horror movie and it's a horror movie to me. I know that there are the jump scare ones and there are the, you know, like the psychological that scares you when you kind of think about the stuff that happened in them. So I'm not a really big fan of jump scares, and not because I get scared. Usually the people I watch it with, if I don't watch it alone, they get scared and they scare me, as like they jump or they make some noise or something next to me. That's what it scares me and not the movie, which is funny. I just like the typical horror movie, you know, with some cool villains or cool monster and, you know, just the typical. I like horror comedy as well and I like horror musicals as well, so yeah. I don't think I have a favorite or best horror movie made for children. Is there such a category, horror movies made for children? Because this is a completely new thing for me. Child's Play. By the way, I remember back when I was a kid, I saw Child's Play and I was super scared of Chucky. I was never scared of Fred Krueger or any of the other villains, I was scared of Chucky. So, yeah, I don't know, a movie made for children, I don't think there is such a horror movie genre. So yeah, if you know the answer for this question or your opinion for this question, please leave a comment below because I'm really, really curious if there's such a movie out there. Horror movie title that best describes your ex. Seriously? I'm just not going to answer that. best non-Halloween holiday horror movie. It's not really a horror movie, but, you know, a creepy movie. And that is obviously Nightmare Before Christmas. I mean, it has two of the best holidays ever in it. Halloween and Christmas. And it just, I think it fits perfectly. So yeah. The best Stephen King horror movie. Fun fact, I actually never saw any of them. I want to watch some because, again, something to add to that watch list that I want to see and I haven't yet. The only ever movie that I saw that was based on a Stephen King novel was It. So I have to choose that like right now, but I don't know, in the future that may change. Best horror movie based on true events. That's again a good question because I don't know which one was based on true events. Probably the, maybe the Conjuring and Insidious were those based on true events, or kind of Annabelle was kind of based on true events too. So I have no idea. I wish I knew more that were based on true events. I don't know. I can't really choose. I knew that there were some of them, but yeah, I just can't choose because I'm not certain which one was based on true events, and I don't want to say anything stupid. And the last question is the best horror movie death. So there were so many great death scenes out there that is just one of the most iconic ones is that when, again, the Nightmare on Elm Street movies, when Freddy pulls the girl inside the TV. So that was one of the probably the best ones. And I don't know, Hellraiser had some really good ones as well, some really interesting ones. So yeah, I can't really choose just one. So yeah, I'm going to choose that one with the girl and the TV because that's what just popped into my mind right now. And yeah, so that's about it for this Halloween challenge. I hope it wasn't too boring, and I hope you don't mind that I wasn't able to like actually answer all of the questions. Like, I'm not being correctly because there is no correct answer, but you know what I'm talking about. I was uncertain on some questions because I can easily forget just movies that didn't really mean anything to me. So yeah, but I still hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up and comment down below. You can actually write your answers down below to these questions, because if I can still find the challenge thing on the internet, I'm going to post the questions in the description box below. So yeah, you can answer them as well. I'm really interested in your opinion and what's your favorite and not so much favorite movies. And yeah, so subscribe if you want to see more videos like this and other kind of, you know, toy and or reviews that I make on my channel. And again, I wish you a happy, happy Halloween, everyone, and be safe out there if you're going to trick or treat, or yeah, if you are giving out some candy to the children, be careful, because you know, you have no clue who's hiding behind that mask. And yeah, so thank you so much for watching. Bye.